Hello everyone, this is Apurva Jain from Griva Capital. Devyani International, the single largest operator of marquee quick service restaurants such as KFC, Costa Coffee and Pizza Hut, is coming up with an IPO of worth Rs. 1838 crores, out of which Rs. 440 crores is a fresh issue and Rs. 1398 is an offer for sale. The company has set the price band at Rs. 86 to 90 per share with a lot size of 165 shares. The issue will be available for subscription from 4th to 6th August. 75% of the entire issue will be reserved for qualified institutional buyers, while 15% will be kept for the non-institutional investors and remaining 10% for retail investors. After the successful listing of Burger King India and Barbecue Nation Hospitality, Devyani International is the third restaurant chain to raise funds through an IPO in the last 1 year. The net proceeds from the IPO will be utilized towards the following objectives. Number one, for the prepayment or repayment of company's borrowing fully or partially. And number two, for general corporate purposes. Those who have not checked our other IPO reviews must check out our reviews on Clean Science Technology, GR Infra Projects and Zomato. All these three IPOs rewarded us with 100% gains, and we told that this will show more than 100% returns within a week of listing. So do check out them. If you have not subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe it now. Now let's get started with the IPO analysis of the company first. Incorporated in 1991, Devyani International Limited is the largest franchisee of Yum Brands and among the largest quick service restaurants chain operators in India. Yum Brands operates many fast food brands like Pizza Hut, KFC and Taco Bell. The company operates in three business verticals. The first is the core brands, which includes KFC, Pizza Hut and Costa Coffee stores in India. The second is the international businesses, which includes stores in foreign countries like Nepal, Nigeria and many others. And third is the other businesses, which includes own branded stores like Vango, Food Street, Masala Twist, Crush Juice Bar and many others. If we see the revenue segments of the core brands of the company like Pizza Hut, KFC, Taco Bell, we see that in FY21, almost 56.77% of the total revenues has been contributed by KFC itself, while Pizza Hut has contributed 25.37% and Costa Coffee has contributed only 1.88%. Initially, the business was started with a Pizza Hut store in Jaipur, but the company expanded operations in both KFC and Pizza Hut. As of March 31, 2021, it operates in 264 KFC stores, 297 Pizza Hut stores and 44 Costa Coffee stores in India. Now, if we talk about the strengths of the company, we see that the company has more than 655 stores in India, which are located in 26 states and 3 union territories. It also has a strong presence in metropolitan cities. The company has a product portfolio of well-recognized QSR brands and is among the single largest QSR companies in India, which is listed on Swiggy and Zomato in the calendar year 2019 and 2020. Also, the company has the largest franchisee of a US-based restaurant chain called the Yum Brands in India. Yum Brands operates restaurants under the top three brands in India, such as KFC, Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. The company has been in business for about 20 years. Along with that, the company also has a highly qualified and experienced management team with experience in all aspects of business. Now, since every company has some weaknesses, let's study about the weaknesses of this company. The company is in agreement with Yum Brands for the rights, and the inability to renew these agreements can ultimately weaken the company's position. Also, since the company is planning to expand its stores, failing to identify proper locations can ultimately backfire the company's plans and its finances. Also, the company has suffered a loss in the last three financial years, which is also a worrying sign. Now, let's talk about the opportunities of the company. The growing QSR segment, with changing lifestyle and eating habits of the younger generation, can act as a fuel to fire for the company's growth. The QSR is expected to grow at a stunning rate of 12.4% until 2025. Not only this, the QSR is expected to witness rapid growth in the number of transactions and number of outlets. Also, the company can use the raised money from the IPO to clear up the debt of Rs. 3578.30 crores, which will make the company debt-free. And once it is debt-free, it can focus on expanding its operations and increase its market share. Lastly, moving on to the threats of the company, we see that the company may also face risk of less brand recognition as compared to its competitor brands. Also, negative publicity of such brands can have a bad impact on sales growth of the company. We can take the example of Burger King, which faced negative publicity for serving halal chicken. Also, COVID-19 and lockdowns had a significant effect on the restaurant sector. The company also faces huge threats from the new concept of cloud kitchen, wherein restaurants will have no physical space to sell their foods and can sell from other delivery platforms directly. Now, let's move on to the competitive analysis of the company. The company faces fierce competition from rivals like Domino's, Burger King, McDonald's, Subway, Haldiram's, and the new concept of cloud kitchen. If we look, Devyani has increased its outlet count to 504 by 2020. That's an addition of nearly 100 outlets in just 1 year. With an outlet count of 605 by 2021, it's on its way to compete with the giants like Jubilant FoodWorks. If you look at the market capitalization, Jubilant FoodWorks has the highest market capitalization of Rs. 48,000 crores and Devyani International has a market capitalization of only Rs. 12,000 crores, which is almost 25% of Jubilant FoodWorks. The company is yet to turn a profit-making company. In fact, of all the competitors, only Jubilant FoodWorks made profits in 2020. Now, let's look at the financial picture of the company. The company's revenue was in an upward direction except in financial year 2021 due to lockdown and the complete closure of operations in March and April of 2020. The revenue has decreased from 2020 to 2021. If we look at the profits, we see that the company has been a loss-making company for the last 3 years and the company operates on very thin operating margins. Also, since the company is a loss-making company, we cannot calculate its P/E ratio. We are ultra bullish on this IPO for listing gains and even for long-term potential. We genuinely believe that this stock will give us listing gains of 50 to 70% and will complete its 100% returns within 2 to 3 days of listing from the IPO price. What makes us so super bullish on this stock? The first reason is the issue is very small size of Rs. 1838 crores and there is a mad rush and investors' appetite for IPOs and smaller issues will get more traction due to demand-supply mismatch. The second reason is the issue is a play on rising consumerism, growing population, proxy play to urbanization and changing lifestyle of Indian consumers, which provides a long roadway to growth for many years to come. The third reason is the company operates in a strong segment of QSR with very strong brand names. There is an inherent competitive advantage which will help it to survive the competition and will be amongst the top 3 players in terms of market share. Strong brand name with a strong operating history makes this company a good bet for the long term. The people who missed the story in Jubilant FoodWorks, which came on January 2010 at an IPO price of Rs. 145 per share, is now at Rs. 3700 and has given almost 34.48% CAGR returns, which means that it has multiplied investors' wealth by roughly 25 times in 11 years. People will call consumer companies expensive, and they will always remain expensive because of the longevity of growth available in the Indian consumer space. We all need to look at these companies with different mindsets. The stock will compound at steady rate and will pick real growth and valuations re-rating once the company starts to generate profits. Then it can become a free cash flow generating machines. So all in all, Devyani International is a great IPO investment bid to be applied for listing gains, but investors should also hold the stock for long term as a portfolio bet rather than rushing to sell the stock on the listing day. The views expressed here are personal. Investors should consult their financial advisor before taking any investment decisions. If you really like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks. This is Apurva Jain signing off from Griva Desk.